So how's it going, guys and girls? It is Oakley here, and today with you guys, it's going to be a video about immigration and stuff. It's a bit of a taboo topic on YouTube. Not many people like to talk about it and give their own opinions on it. However, I feel that we, as a collective group of individuals, all seem to respect one another's opinions, and you'll respect the fact that this is mine. I respect that you've got yours and you're entitled to that. However, I wanted to discuss something that I saw on Facebook, and it actually was a result of a TV show called Gogglebox, which I've spoken about before. One of the things they were watching was a new segment about the immigration laws, the fact that Romania and I believe it was Bulgaria are soon to be able to like have free right of passage into the UK, into England, due to the fact that we're in the European Union. And this kind of, somebody mentioned it on Facebook and it sparked up this debate. And I sit there and I look at some of the stuff that people say, and it irritates me to the point at which I actually get angry. And some people saying, and I understand that some people get affected by immigration in different ways. Now, what I wanted to talk to you guys about was my idea of what would actually make a difference and how it could be like for the betterment of, I guess, like people that live in the UK already, but then also people that wanted to come over. Now, one of the arguments was that the thing that really pissed me off, people who say get them, literally they say get them out. And that really fucks me off, because if you go onto these people's pages, like some of them I don't know, I'm not friends with them. I don't choose to be friends with people like that with that mental attitude. Gone to their, and they've got like an Irish surname, or they've got ancestry that they're half black or something like that. And it's like myself, my mum's a second generation like from Ireland, and my dad's like came over himself from another country. And it's kind of like, why? And you and the people who are saying get them out, by their same reasoning, they themselves shouldn't be in this fucking country. And like, everyone in England is essentially a freaking immigrant. And at some stage or another in time, and it really pisses me off when they say that. And they say this stuff like, oh, they come over and steal all of our jobs. That's another load of fucking shit, because that's bollocks. That is absolute bullshit. People go from another country trying to better their lives, and if they're willing to do that, and they're willing to take the jobs that we ourselves are too, like, you know, proud to do, like, say, for example, you know, stereotypically saying, like, cleaning, etc., etc., what the fuck are you on about? Like, it annoys me so, so much when people say that. And yeah, I understand that some of their parents, maybe if they're in construction, maybe getting undercut by prices that they are not willing to go down to, but, you know, other people coming in, other immigrants coming in may go down to like a certain level, and it's really, really bad for the people in that industry. But for the people who are buying those goods and services from an economic perspective, it's good. It's competition, and that's what you need. You don't want to have like a monopoly. I just knocked off a bauble. Going festive, by the way, with the Christmas tree. You don't want a monopoly market. You want to have like a free market where there's like loads of different people to select from. And I, as I said, I do understand the fact that too much of that is a bad thing. You don't want to have all of these other people that coming in and then not spending the money in the country that they're earning it. They're, you know, sending it home or whatnot. I can understand that argument. I do understand it. And I think we should be a little bit more stringent on people who are coming into the country. But the attitude of get them out and not letting anybody in, that is a load of shit. And if you actually believe that, then you're a bigot. You're an absolute bigot. The thing that David Cameron said, that his way of targeting that on the show was to impose a 3-month ban. Like, you're not, for the first 3 months you come over to this country, you're not allowed to claim, you know, job seekers, you're not allowed to go on the dole. Another load of crap. That is the most idiotic solution to the problem that I've ever heard in my life. Like, if you look at Australia, it's very difficult to get a permit to live in Australia. And America, like, we are one of the easiest countries to get into. There's no doubt about it. I think there should be some regulation going on there, 110%. I'm not saying that everyone should be allowed in. I'm just saying, what I'm trying to say is that it shouldn't not be allowed. However, the way in which Cameron wants to target this is he wants to impose a 3-month period where you're not allowed to claim job seekers or anything from the government for the first 3 months you come into this country, which is the most stupid thing I've ever heard in my life. Like, if you're coming, unless he's using it as a deterrent to come to this country, but if you're trying to come over here and you're here for the right reasons, you're here to work, you're here to earn money, spend it here, trying to set up a new life in this country, which you're entitled to if you're in the European Union, the first 3 months are going to be the hardest months in that transaction. They're going to be the months where you actually need, where you've got a valid excuse to be on the dole or needing benefits because you've just come to a new frickin' country. Like, you've got no help, you don't know anyone here, or assumably you don't know anyone here. So that's been the hardest months. You've got to find a job. If it's hard enough for us to find jobs, what the fuck are they going to do? Do you know what I mean? It just seems so stupid. What I think is that they should be allowed for, say, a grace period of 6 weeks. They should be allowed to have that to get themselves on their feet. If they're not doing that, that's when you put the 3 month ban in, so they can't claim after that. It just seems so stupid. I just don't understand it. But this is the reason why I'm doing this video. So I want to see your thoughts on that situation. As always, you know how to get in, you know, get in the comment section. Let's get a little bit of a debate going. But all in all, I just think it's so stupid, and I think it's moronic. The one thing I really can't stand when it comes to immigration and that sort of stuff is the people who say, get them out, or we shouldn't let anybody in, because that is a load of crap. I think it should be more stringent. I do think that it is too easy to come into this country, 110%. But what I can't stand is the fact that it's the people who are saying it tend to be the people who themselves are first, second, maybe even third generation of an immigrant themselves. And it's just the height of idiocy, and I cannot stand it. But that's my little rant over on the subject. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed it. If you have, as I said, please do be sure to drop a like rating down below. And the main thing I really would love to see from you guys is a little bit of discussion going on. Like, what do you think? Do you agree with what I'm saying? Have you got your own views on the matter? As I said, some of you may, you know, you might have completely bipolar opposite opinions to me. You may think that not many people at all should be allowed in this country, but with a valid reason, rather than just saying, oh, get them out. If your dad or mother may be in construction, and you may feel that there's too many people coming over and there's too much competition to the point at which you can't actually make a profit and you can't run that business because they are just doing it for too cheap. They're just you know, willing to live in conditions that you cannot, sort of thing. That's what I'm looking for in the comment section down below. But yeah, on that note, I've been Oakley. You guys are absolutely fantastic. Hopefully you've enjoyed it. I'll speak to you all soon. Have a great day and goodbye.